Hi guys, this is Jim from Yankee Gold Prospecting, and today I want to go over something that I don't think I've made any videos on. I may have mentioned it, but in any case, a lot of the information that is online or was online when I first started prospecting or panning seems to be information that came from out west, whether it's California or Alaska or wherever. I'm guessing California for the most part, because that's where most of the gold in the United States came from originally. And so that's where books are written about it. And one of the things they talk about is digging under tree roots, or roots in general. And the roots have nothing to do with holding the gold in place. And this, in particular, this spot is proof of that. And, you know, if that was the case, there would be, you know, because, first of all, these might not be tree roots, but it's grass. And it's like miner's moss because of the roots. So you can see all these roots right are down here. And I could totally dig this because the high banks up here by the branches down here or whatever. But you can see like all of these roots right here. And I could shake that out and I might get a color or two. But really there's not much there. And once you rip those grasses out and the roots out, what happens is this will all get tore up, and then eventually you'll lose this whole section in most of the other rocks and gravels will wash down. It's still legal for the most part because it's within the high water marks, or the average high water mark, I should say, in New Hampshire and Vermont. You can only dig within the average high water mark. So, in any case, I think I prospected an area right up in here by this big rock, and I had trenched the water through here, and you know, to try to get some of the fine sands to wash out and everything. And there was some grass here, and when I panned it, I only got a couple colors. But yet, right down here, and you can see there's some grass right there at the edge of this, the water line. But right behind this rock here, the bigger one that you can see underwater, right behind there, I was getting 15 colors in the pan. So much more color in the water than there is in the grass and the roots, at least from what I've found so far. And I've done this a couple times and checked it, and, you know, checked the roots and everything, and, you know, just really nothing there. So the gold really doesn't hold because of, or it doesn't get stuck because of those roots. If anything, it's like a hard pan without any gravels on top of it to protect the gold, so everything seems to wash right down. And Hurricane Irene swept through here, and it really didn't leave any extra color here, except in the creek. So don't worry, you know, you can check spots like that, but I'm telling you, you know, I can see where guys have dug in here. I've backfilled it a little bit. And, you know, some guys have dug this out and stuff. And they really have gotten no color. And I just saw a worm here. I'll throw it into the trout. And in any case, there's really not that much there. So, you know, stick to the creeks. Do not dig under the high banks. It's really not worth it. You may find color, and it's easy to dig. But I see so many people doing it, and it is just ridiculous. Because for the most part, it might be easier to dig the material, but you find way less gold. You know, and that's what I really try to prove by doing my videos, is that I find a lot more color just by digging in the water. You know, and I look for inside bends, but even, you know, like this far side with those big rocks, that's going to have color over there too. So just really depends on the location. It's all location, location, location. And there will be gold in the river. So stay in the river, out of the high banks.